these wanted, ant-legged, creepy-eyed, what-looking monsters could only be from one movie. Plan B. A horror movie that disguises itself as a budget alternative to the popular Jerry Seinfeld movie, B-Movie. In this video, I'll try to sum up and review Plan B in a way that is hopefully less offensive to your eyes than just showing you it. As you can see, this movie is iconic for its awful design and poor choice of colour palettes. This mess of a movie was thrown up by Sparkplug Entertainment. The creators of all this that's happening on your screen right now. They're a New York-based animation company that specializes in making fever dream mockbusters of popular animated films.
I found you, faker!
They release them hoping people get confused and waste their money on the rip-off instead of the real thing. Business practices aside, we need to talk about the plot of this movie. To begin with, we get introduced to the characters, starting off with a hero for this journey, Bing. The leader of a group of worker bees, the first of which is Buffy. She's an annoying, oh my god, no way, type of girl, and the sole purpose in this movie is to complain. She does literally nothing else, so I'm not going to talk about it for the rest of this video. Speaking of doing nothing, there's the next bee, Joey. He's eating the flowers, as he's the fat one. And eating is his sole character trait. To continue with the theme of basic character traits that provide nothing to the story, we meet our third bee, Zips. He's felt to be the dumb one, as he's trying to pollinate a pretzel. Though you might find it odd to focus on Zips in this scene, as it introduces arguably the creepiest thing in the entire movie, the thing that truly makes this a horror. The bees have a fleshy tube for a tongue that they use to pollinate the flowers. It's disgusting. They make it worse by playing a slurping sound effect over it. Of note, bees don't even use their tongues to collect nectar, they use their feet. Which, if this movie was good, they'd probably have bees do like a little nectar dance or something to do with their feet, but no. They went with a pepper army tongue instead. Should have took the Tarantino approach. That said, we have one more bee left to meet. And while you need to hear their voice.
Pistol! We won't make much.
Honey? Oh, we'll make plenty.
Not with this motley crew, we won't.
Yeah, that's Pistol. He's the one who complains about everything, meaning we now have two characters whose sole purpose within this movie is to complain. Lovely. We don't have to worry about Pistol too much though, as he gets thrown into a 360 by a mysterious bee named Bowser. He's going to be the two-dimensional villain of this story. Bell's mysterious appearance causes Bing and the rest of the troops to retreat to the hive, which just so happens to be across from the White House. This is going to be very subtle messaging of themes to come. Once in the hive, it's time to start their demonic ritual of filling a crevice with honey using their meat tongues. This ritual requires a little dance that Pistol does, which will turn the nectar to honey. Whilst doing this, out of nowhere, we get an announcement that Queen Akeeth is coming. This causes mass confusion amongst our characters, as that's not their queen. Akeeth arrives and tells the bees that the old queen has been exiled, so she's the queen now. Then to flex a new position, Akeeth starts having a go at all the bees for not producing enough honey, and tells them that they need to drill and drain. Drilling and draining is a new method of collecting nectar that collects more, but destroys the flower in the process. Bing isn't happy about this new method, but Akeeth's the boss now, so he agrees. Speaking of Akeeth, let's talk about it for a second. Akeeth's a surprisingly serviceable villain. The monster-ish looking bee design works for her as a villain character, and her voice actor does an okay job. She's probably the only character I actually remember when thinking back about this movie.
I want more honey now!
Back to the events of the story. Now, Bing is getting on his troops' nerves by telling them to drill and drain while collecting nectar. After a bit of whinging from the bees, we get introduced to a new bee, named Bonnie. She is a friend of Bing's from another hive. Whilst Bing's making boring small talk with Bonnie, the old queen, that was set up literally a scene ago, just walks by. And it's revealed that no one knows why she was kicked out of the hive, and she's currently living with Bonnie. More importantly though, Bowser took advantage of the time used for exposition to steal the troops' nectar. Bing notices, so Bowser and the troops rush back to the hive. Once back at the hive, it's time to fill the crevice with honey once again. The troops don't have enough
nectar.
Leaves them getting another turn off from a key. Going to start the cycle of them not having enough honey and getting told off.
It's a really fun cycle.
Anyway, to rub salt in the troops' wounds, a key promotes Belzer to major during this scene. It becomes very obvious that Belzer hates Bing. If you're wondering why, don't. We never find out. They just seem to dislike each other. Ignoring the bee, in our next scene we cut to a church where Bing's praying to be in a better movie and sulking because he's struggling to meet the Queen's demands. Luckily though, Bonnie arrives to comfort him and we find out she's considered a radical, wants to revolt against the key as she believes in liberty. During this scene it becomes clear she gets along well with Bing, so she tries to speed a relationship with him by inviting him to live at her hive. Bing isn't ready for this just yet, so he says even though it's an easy solution to his problems, as the hive she lives in doesn't believe in overworking bees. Bing's reasoning for this is that he needs to lead the troops, but I honestly don't see why he doesn't just bring them with him. Also, fun bee fact I found while doing research, switching hives isn't uncommon for worker bees, and it's referred to as drifting. Anyway, Bing returns to the hive, where Keith reveals she's hosting a competition to see who can produce the most honey, and the loser might get banished. Although, that wouldn't be wise, as in this scene we find out the hive only has 17 bees, including the queen, which is a lot less than the average 20 to 80,000. During this scene we get a better view of the hive, and the drab core palette combined with the fact it's got zero population basically, just makes it feel like a wasteland, and not a bustling hive like that in Bee Movie. It's quite a bad thing for the movie, as the movie already looks really dull. Anyway. Back to the plot, where Bing is scared by the thought that he and his troops might be banished, so he gets everyone to drill and drain at the usual spot. This is despite the fact that it's only a couple scenes ago we find out that there is a hive accepting the refugees of Akeef, and they do seem to be accepting new applications, as shown with the old queen and the fact Bonnie's inviting Bing. Acknowledging a hive for the refugees, and the fact that Akeef's hive only has about 7 bees, you basically feel zero tension in the scene, and I can't relate to the stress at all, as they clearly have alternatives that are pretty good. So when it comes to Akeef banishing bees for losing a competition, it's basically a stakeless competition at this point. As mentioned, there's alternatives. Should probably just use that one brain cell that they share and move into the other hive. Although, that would make the movie only 11 minutes long, and what would I do without more flan bee in my life? Anyway, the bees go back to their regular spot and are having trouble with the fact that they can't get any nectar from the flowers. Not to worry though, Bing has a genius idea of storming the Washington Monument to steal the nectar from the flowers there. Although, Pistol has a problem with this, as he sets up the fact that it's a special day today, and that there will most likely be a massive crowd around the Washington Monument, just for them to get there and it'd be completely empty, except for a toad. Fun fact about that toad, it has the same voice actor as Pistol, despite it just being a frog and making frog noises. The toad must be an undercover agent for the FBI, as it's protecting a picture of George Washington surrounded by flowers, seemingly from bees that have a genius idea to attack it. The troops just somehow easily fly by the guard, and Zips goes to drill and drain the flowers, but because he's a bit slow, he ends up just headbutting them instead. Bing does manage to get the bees to start pollinating the flowers, but Pistol isn't too happy about disrespecting Washington's memorial. So Bing tries to convince him by using the master argument of Washington loving honey, which is an undeniable fact. But it wasn't enough, as Pistol starts to show signs of intelligence,
pointing out the irony of them needing to steal nectar for a key
from the guy who granted America freedom from an evil monarch. That said, we know logic doesn't work on Bing, as he's too whipped. So he goes back to managing the troops. Also, yeah, the message of this movie is freedom and liberty, which I guess makes sense. As fun bee fact, bees live in a democracy, where the worker bees get to choose who the queen is. Anyway, back to the plot, where Belzer spawns in to disturb the toad, and we get our first action scene during this movie. The frog starts attacking the bees frantically with its tongue, as it doesn't know who stung it, and well, Pistol was unable to dodge. We unfortunately get our first death of the movie, and we're going to have to say goodbye to Pistol. Not that the troops are bothered, they need to go back to the hive for a key's competition. Once back at the hive, it's crevice time, but once full, they finally realise Pistol is missing, as they need him to do the
dance.
Luckily though, Bonnie followed them to the hive, and she does the dance instead. The troops look to have a lot of honey, which means it's now time for Belzer to mess things up. Belzer, unable to take an L, starts stealing the troops' honey, breaking several bee laws in the process. Belzer ends up winning, but despite losing, the bees aren't kicked out because Akeef realised she needs them for honey. So the stakeless competition somehow has even lower stakes. We get another scene where Bonnie talks sense to Bing, but obviously he just ignores her. So then we go back to the hive, where we get to hear Zips say something for the first time in the movie. And well, he sounds like this.
In this business,
Lovely. We just got rid of Pistol and we get another lovely voice to replace him. Anyway, it's bedtime for the bees and they turn off the voice activated lights of the hive and try to go to sleep. When Belzer shows up, he informs them they have been demoted from worker bees to slave bees, as they're now on a 24/7 contract. So we get a minute long montage of the bees aimlessly flying around to show, I guess it's to show them working. It doesn't convey that at all. Of note, a minute feels like 10 when you're watching this movie, and the boring appeal of the designs wore off about a good 6 minutes ago. After the montage, we see all the bees exhausted because of all the work they've done. But you know, Bonnie's here to solve their problems once again, and she tells Bing there's a place with lots of flowers so they can collect as much nectar as they want. With as much nectar as they want, they should be able to get some sleep. Bing actually accepts Bonnie's advice for once, and they head over to the location. And, well, it's a dumpster. In an alleyway. But it is full of flowers, as the restaurant behind throws away their table flowers every day so the troops can get to work and they collect the nectar. Once done, they go back to the hive, where they wait for Keen. She's annoyed and demands they bring her royal jelly. I don't know what royal jelly is, but they need to go and get her some. So, they go to the Old Queen, and it's just some pointless B-plot to let us know the Old Queen's kicked out by the elders. Not that important. Bing gets back to the hive and delivers the jelly to Akeef.
And for some reason, we get Akeef's backstory.
She grew up being told she would never be queen, because she was too nice. So that's why she's so mean.
We don't get long to think about that Oscar-winning backstory though, as Belzer's here once again. And this time he's here to snitch about them getting jelly from the Old Queen.
So, Akeef banishes Bonnie for some reason, Bing gets a telling off. Honestly, at this point in the movie, boredom's truly kicked in, and I kinda just want a kid to start throwing rocks at the hive. But there is a bit of drama coming up, as we cut to the bees, bonked out with exhaustion in the dumpster.
And,
oh no. We hear a heart rate machine as the lid of the bin closes on the troops, causing Bing to get separated from them. It turns out the heart rate machine that we heard was not for attention. It was a green car reversing before it drags the bin away behind it, leaving Bing all alone, with the rest of the troops going to the same landfill I imagine the copies of this movie went to, probably to face a Toy Story 3 style ending.
This scene's the first time I managed to laugh in this movie, and it's 31 minutes into a 40 minute movie. To make it worse, it's not even me laughing with the movie, it's me laughing at the movie. That they couldn't even get a sound effect for a car reversing, or the model of a garbage truck. I guess what was I expecting from a B-movie ripoff? Back to the plot, where Bing has a mini breakdown before we go back to the hive, where he's all alone and sulking. Akeef and Belzer start to interrogate about where's the honey, but that was it for Bing. He finally snaps and tells Akeef to screw her honey before going into a little Joker moment.
Bye bye Bing.
Get out!
Akeef, freaked out by Bing's insanity, calls the guards to surround Bing and force him to leave.
You violated the law.
He flees to some flowers with his sting between his gross ant legs, where the Old Queen and Bonnie are collecting nectar. He tells them he's been kicked out and that he's happy to be out of the quote-unquote sweatshop. So, the Old Queen reveals to him she was kicked out by the elders, after they tasted royal jelly. And somehow, Bing puts the pieces together and figures out what's happened. I don't get how he did this, considering with all the setup for his character, he's been shown to be a complete and utter moron. But we'll go with it, if it helps the movie finish quicker. With this new knowledge in mind, he heads for the hive with Bonnie and the Old Queen, but before we find out what's going to happen to Bing, somehow the troops have had been trapped in a dumpster, and are now back at the hive being scolded by Akeef.
What a surprise, another scolding from Akeef.
She reasonably decides they need to be beheaded, but before anything can happen, Bing swoops in to save the day. And this next scene, it's weird. It becomes a mini court drama.
Order in the court.
I assume they must have heard about the B-movie court scene, despite it not being in any trailers, and it's forced upon the plot here. So Bing starts making a Saul Goodman speech to the jury in the hive, about his troops being innocent. The jury agrees with him, but Bing isn't done with his speech just yet, as he now accuses Akeef of being an awful queen, and demands the reason as to why she's queen. The elders tell him apparently the Old Queen poisoned their jelly, and Bing quickly realises it was Akeef's doing all along, so he calls her out on this shit. Upon hearing the allegations, Akeef declares martial law, and yeah, that's what she actually says. So she kicks out the elders. She summons her guards to get rid of the troops, and well, it leads to the best fight scene in movie history. I can't do the fight scene any justice. Marvel couldn't do the fight scene any justice. You need to see the spark plug original. So I'm just going to show you it.
How was this made? They are literally just something in the air. This is insane. It would take a genuine insane person to look at this and go, yeah, this is good. Are you hearing the groaning? They're groaning. It's ridiculous. How? This looks awful.
With all the brutal humping of stingers and groaning out of the way, the fight's finally over, and Akeef is about to leave the hive, where she follows in the footsteps of all great villains, and claims she'll be back. But before she can finish her speech, the toad from earlier appears and eats her. Turns out Pistol wasn't eaten, and he managed to tame the toad, so that's good for him, I guess. Anyway, it's the end of the movie, the old queen is the queen again, and Bing asked Bonnie to live at the hive with him. They all live happily ever after. Cut to credits. This movie's bad. The colour palette of multiple scenes just looks like eye vomit. And despite the movie having 3D models, they choose 2D backdrops. Which, that style can work, as shown in like Final Fantasy VII, but it really doesn't here. The movie has 12 characters, including the frog. And most of them annoying voices, which is just made worse by the fact that they constantly complain for the most part. The movie has a boring cycle of the bees not getting honey, going back to the hive, and then getting told off by Akeef. And this loops multiple times, and it's really repetitive and annoying. The loop's made worse by the fact the characters are just boring, and honestly, very unintelligent. They seriously share one brain cell, and it just leads to a plot where you can't
empathise
with any of the characters or their decisions. The sole purpose of this movie is for it to be made fun of, and to steal some money from some unsuspected people. That said, I wasn't expecting much. It is a mockbuster of B-movie at the end of the day, and at least the final fight scene was funny, and the one time they use a heart monitor for a car reversing. So, overall, I guess it gets a Bluster Kong out of 10. Gotta say, I'm waiting for the day they release a Spark Plug Entertainment equivalent of Avengers Endgame. Truly gonna be hype.